Hi, and welcome to this video tutorial series on using the SunBurn editor. In this first video, we will show you some of the basics of using the editor while getting acclimated to its layout. First, let's start up the editor. To do this, run your game through Visual Studio, then press F11, the editor launch key. Now let's get familiar with the layout. This top area is the properties panel where you can change values for objects. It is a tabbed panel, so selecting different tabs will allow you to edit different types of objects. On the left is the toolbox, which will display buttons for saving, undoing, redoing, and other tab-specific functions. Save, undo, and redo all operate on a per-tab basis, meaning actions in the Lights tab will not undo when you press the Undo button in the Materials tab. The same goes for saving. Pressing the Save button only saves the current tab. Below this area is the SunBurn game window. This is your game running in real time. You can interact with the game as you would normally and edit it at the same time. You can move around the camera with standard first-person controls, using WASD to move, and right-click with the mouse to look. These panels to the left and right are rollout panels. They can be moved, resized, and docked on one another. They hover over your SunBurn game window and can be collapsed to give you as much space to view your game as necessary. The right rollout panel is your selection tree view. This is where you select the objects you want to edit. Each tab uses this selection panel to list all the objects available for editing. Clicking objects in this list will select them, and holding Ctrl or Shift will multi-select. The left rollout panel changes depending on the current tab. For the Scene Objects and Lights tab, it will display content repositories. A content repository stores models and prefabs. It is how you get your assets into the editor. Prefabs and models can be dragged and dropped onto the selection panel to add them to the current scene. The Materials, Custom Effects, and Terrain tabs will instead display the texture browser. This panel will show all the textures in your content folder and display them in a directory tree view. You can filter and search your textures, then drag and drop them onto a texture map to assign it to a material. In the next video, we will go over the different tabs and what objects they edit.